Hey guys, welcome to my channel. It's Little C here. And as you can see, this is my new Nano Leaf Rhythm Light. It provides very cool effects behind me, changing colors as I talk. Really cool, I like it a lot. So today, I'll be showing you 8 tips to hopefully help you befriend your skin again. Why? Because I've been abusing my skin using makeup products, dirty sponges and brush, not giving it proper care and love for quite some time now. Like this video if you feel as guilty as me. So, time's up. Let's get started to a new beginning.
Mix 1 part castor oil and 3 part coconut oil. Stir the mixture into a smooth and apply on your dry skin. This mixture will help to take away your makeup or any other applications that you have on your face. Make sure you massage it over your face. This is like my favorite step because it feels really nice and soothing. When you're done, rinse it with warm water and repeat if required. This DIY oil cleanser will bring out the impurity in your skin and wipe away your makeup. As you can see, a lot of my makeup is wiped away. Now I'm just using the baby wipe to wipe away any last remainder. And now my face is as clean as ever. So try this. Soak your sponge in warm water and squeeze out all the product as much as you can. Get a brush or something that has a grip just like this. Put a bit of soap on it. I use this one as a makeup brush cleanser from e.l.f. I love it so much because it takes off the makeup product a lot better than a normal soap. Put the sponge and the brush underneath the water. Rub the surface of the sponge over the brush, and there you have it. You have a clean sponge that's not stained at all. You can do the same for your makeup brushes as well. Side tip though, when you're stressed out, try squeezing the makeup sponge. It is so satisfying. But then again, that just might be me. Mix a little bit of lemon juice with white sugar to create a scrub-like texture. Rub that over the area with blackhead and it will help to pull them out. When you're done, wash your face with warm water. So before I use my apple cider vinegar, I shake it up a little bit so the liquid inside is well mixed. I use 1 part apple cider vinegar and 3 part boiled water. Make sure the boiled water is warm and not hot. You can also replace it with distilled water as well. Mix it up and apply over concerned area as a toner. This is great for people that have acne all over their face with red spots. If you don't like the apple cider vinegar smell, you can apply your regular toner over it to mask the smell. So this next step is good if you have sparse pimples or acne all over your face. You're gonna need distilled or boiled water, sea salt, some Epsom salt, and essential oil if you like. I use lavender to add a little bit of relaxation to it. The sea salt spray will help to dry up the pimple and the salt will help to nourish your skin as well. This can be used as a toner and then you can put your moisturizer over it. Now if you have spotty pimple, try putting toothpaste over them before you go to bed. It should help to dry them up overnight. A note of warning though, if you're not a person to sleep upright, you may not want to do this because toothpaste is a bit sticky and you're going to wake up with toothpaste all over your bed. Use wisely, with discretion, of course. So this is the aloe vera gel that I use. And unfortunately, the design sucks, so it's taking me some time to get the aloe out of it. But I finally got it out. Applying it on my face right now, and to my surprise, it's actually very soothing and hydrated. You know, aloe vera gel, a lot of people think it's thick and sticky, but it's actually pretty nice on your face. So try it out if you happen to know. So this is the moisturizer I use. I got it from the face shop. Ooh, that's cold. So I put this moisturizer in the fridge about 2 hours ago. And when I apply it on my face, it actually gives that cold, chilly effect to give you like an instant wake up call. So instead of someone like splashing cold water in your face, you're just applying cold moisturizer on your face instead. It's actually pretty cool.
Well, that's it for today. I hope you know that makeup is just an image enhancer. It's not Photoshop. So you need to take care of your skin as well. Hopefully these tips that I've given you today can help you befriend with your skin once again. Give me one big thumbs up if you like this video or if you thought this like was really cool. Subscribe down below to the Smarty family for more videos just like this. See you next time. Bye!
Bang, 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 bang.
Skin sensitivity level.
Your skin's sensitivity level.
Your skin's sensitivity level. La 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 la. La 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 la. Okay. Now, last but not all.